What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about deploying Microsoft 365 apps updates using SCCM. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is open up our Microsoft Configuration Endpoint Manager. I know I'm constantly saying SCCM, but I'm old school because I just like the way it, you say SCCM. Why not, right? Go for it. So once you open it up, first thing that we need to do is get into administration. We are going to go to overview. Within overview, we are going to go to site configuration. We're going to click on sites. Within sites, we are going to highlight your sites. I only have one site, which is BTN. And from here, I'm going to right click on it. And we are going to go to configure site components, and we are going to pick on software update point. Now, within here, we're going to go to classifications, and a couple of things that we need to do. We got to make sure we have updates, upgrades, and all this other stuff. Now, this is what I have within my environment. You might change it depending on how you want to configure it within your, within your infrastructure. Once you pick your classifications, we are going to head to the products tab, and we're going to go all the way to the bottom until we see the option to select Microsoft 365 apps, Office 2019, and then Office LTSC. We're going to give it a check mark. We're going to click apply, and we're going to OK it. Now, next thing that we need to do is go inside software, go to overview. Within overview, we're going to expand the Office 365 client management folder, and we're going to select on Office 365 updates. Now, I don't have anything in here. We just configured SCCM to actually pull Microsoft Office 365 updates. So at the very top on the left-hand side, we're going to click on synchronize software updates. So click on that, and you should get a nice little dialog box. We're going to click yes here, and just give it some time. If you're don't have any patience like me, you're able to go inside the log folder. And within the log folder, there's a particular log that you're able to double click on, which is called a WSync MGR for manage. And if you double click on that, you go all the way to the bottom, you should see that your WSUS synchronizing updates. Right now, it is updating about 4,108 updates onto my SCCM server. Holy crap, crazy, right? Eventually, you should see some updates pop up, which is always a good thing. Now, let's head back into administration, go to overview, and within here, we're going to click on client settings. Now, I'm going to select my client settings for workstations. There's a couple of things that we need to do to set up, our workstations to push Office 365 updates to. So we're going to double click on that, open it up, and we're going to go into the software update section. On your right hand side, we need to locate enable management of the Office 365 client agent. By default, it is configured to not configure. So click on the drop down menu and then select yes and then OK it. Now we need to go back inside software overview, inside Office 365 client management and Office 365 updates. You should see a crap load of updates pulled down from the Microsoft server online into your SCCM, which is a good thing. Now, automatically, they're not downloaded. Everything is no. So don't freak out. It's not locally downloaded into your SCCM server, so it won't take any space. Now, from here, I'm going to click on Add Criteria, and I'm going to pick Expired, and I'm also going to pick Date Released. And those two options I'm going to configure. If you click on Is On or After, I'm going to do Is Between, and I'm going to pick a nice date range. So I'm going to pick an entire month. And then for and expired, just click on a drop down menu for, by default, it's set to no. So just make sure it's no. And then just hit enter. And it's going to narrow everything down to the range that I selected on the date released. So that's a good thing. So from here, I'm basically going to select two updates. Hold the control key, select whatever updates you want to push out to your infrastructure. I picked these two. I'm going to right click, and we're going to pick on download. Within download, we are going to create a new deployment package. We're going to give it a new name. Now, for the package source, I actually created a new folder within sources called Microsoft 365 updates, and that's where I'm going to drop these updates into. Copy that UNC path into that particular text box and then click on next. We're going to click on add and we are going to pick on distribution point and pick your DP. Once you pick your DP, click OK, and then we're going to click next here. I left the distribution settings for this package as the default, so just click next here. Download location, default, next here. For the updates language for the product, default, click next. A lot of next right now. Summary, click next. It's going to start pulling everything from the Microsoft online server down into your SCCM server. It's actually going to download it into that folder that we provided and give it some time. It should process depending on how many updates you selected. For me, I only did 2, so it didn't take too much. And then you should get a green check mark that is completed and then click on close. Now from here, what you could do is basically go inside add criteria and I'm going to select downloaded and I'm just going to hit enter. And then once you do enter, it's going to basically narrow it down to the 2 updates or several updates that you downloaded. And I'm just going to select them. I'm going to right click on them and I'm going to select on deploy. Now you're going to get the deploy software updates wizard from here. All you need to do is click on the browse button and then select your collection. Now for this video, I picked all workstations and then click OK. And then we are going to click next here. I left the default deployment settings as is, click next. For scheduling, it's up to you, change it, but I left everything as the default, click next. User experience, if you want to hide this from the software center, go for it. I left it as the default to display it, click next. Alerts, default, next. For the download settings, the only thing I did here is make sure the first deployment option, you select download software updates from the DP and install. And if you want, I like the option at the very bottom where it says if the updates are not available on to your DP or the neighbor DP or the boundary groups, you're able to download the content within the Microsoft update server. If you want, that's optional, depends on you, and then click next. Nice little summary, click next, and all green check marks, and then you're good to go. And that's it, guys. That is how we deploy Microsoft 365 apps update to your, you know, workstations using SCCM or MCEM, Microsoft Configuration Endpoint Manager. Who cares? SCCM for me. Hopefully you guys enjoy and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.